Any player, so. One, seven, B flat, seven, one, two, transcribing, you're like, hey man, so-and-so does that, you know, blah blah blah. And you see it even in Michael Brecker's playing. You see it a lot in Michael Brecker's playing. The difference is he won't necessarily do it on the root going, if the not the proper way, but the most common way of using the lick is the root major seven down to dominant seven, up to a nine or up or back to the root, and then 6-5. So or you hear just those two ways, but you hear a lot of, you know, more modern players using that. They just won't use it on the root of a dominant chord. They'll, you know, use it on the sharp four, you know, or use it on the flat six. Say it all the time. So it's, you know, again, you get to that from transcribing. Another common thing, play me a minor, make it a for simplicity's sake, so I don't mess it up. Play an F minor. The sound of what you're playing is the major seven to the dominant seven to the six. So you got play a, just hold the chord. Like a common thing you hear in a progression, play the beginning of a My Funny Valentine. Just first four chords, really. One, two, three, four. Major seven. A lot of people's playing, and sometimes it follows the chord. So, like, if we were playing, and you don't have to play the seventh, just play the triad. One, two, You all have heard players do that, but you also hear it's the same thing. The seventh, what I want you to listen for is. Another common sound, and again, once you start transcribing, that's the thing about transcribing, especially transcribing from a variety of different players and a variety of different instruments, there's things you'll see all the time. And if a cat like, you know, if Red Garland, Oscar Peterson, Pat Martino, Mike Stern, Louis Armstrong, if you see the stuff happening in their language, in their solos, I would think it would be a good idea for you to add that to your own playing. You know, you don't want to overuse any cliche. You know, you want to come up with your own stuff. But there is a common and shared vocabulary between, you know, all the great improvisers of this music, you know, and it would be a great thing if you had some of that in your own playing.